on. I just wanna, I see you sweat, just keep the lights on. Hands up like
it's NBA action. And away we go. Curry. His first effort off the mark.
Great contest by the D, but I want to see the coaching staff call the same exact play the next possession. Get that offensive player the ball. Let him prove that it wasn't the D. It was more in his own head.
It's Steph at the controls to Thompson. And Jay, they call the foul.
That's just a blatant foul. Maybe he's trying to make a statement.
Durant. Curling inside. Oh, Horford up to block the shot. Out of bounds. Last touch by the Celtics. Thompson. Curry gets it to go. Coach cannot be happy with that closeout.
But it was how he created the shot. As a defender, there's a tendency to stand up when you stare at the ball. Offensive player recognized that, continuously moved without the ball. Bang, that's how he set it up.
Green. Fakes, drives to the rim, and scores.
That probably won't be the last time we see a dunk from him tonight. Maybe sometimes you should send a message. Give him a hard foul. Don't let it be so easy.
Brown with the three, with a hand in his face.
Even though the coach initially may not like that shot, now he's clapping because that ball went in.
Knock loose. Celtics have it.
It's early. Get a good quality shot here.
Hayward is good.
And in today's game, you have to make shots like that. Nice work draining it from deep.
It's Steph Curry with the rock. Tight space with the crossover. Curry and buries it. Jay, they'll take that any day. His instincts are unnatural, but what makes him so good given the work he's put in?
The special thing about Stephen Curry is that his entire life he has practiced great habits. A lot of players practice and get up shots, but they don't practice the right habits, and that comes with the lineage. His father, Dale Curry, making sure that he puts in the time and effort, but the proper skill with the time and effort.
And they call the foul. Careful there, Jay.
A simple touch foul.
Durant. Celtics come away with it. Kyrie across the timeline. Up by three. For three, buries the three. He's too good to leave that open.
It's all about creating space with the dribble. Once you have that gap, you can beat somebody in a variety of ways. He chose the gap.
Got a piece of it.
Jumping out the gym right now.
Great anticipation. Has a chance, takes advantage inside after the miss from the perimeter.
Jaylen Brown really coming into his own, the third overall pick a couple of years ago. He saw his points per game go up drastically. Plus, he is one of the few people in the East that has the versatility to guard LeBron James.
Irving to Jaylen Brown. Screen coming.
Hey, watch the screen left.
Inside, he scores.
You see, Ed, skill levels at this game are at an all-time high. Inside-out threats are tough. You got to make it hard for him to actually catch the ball in those higher percentage areas.
Cousins to Thompson. Going to launch. Beyond the arc. No good.
And there's always so much talk about defense. How about offensively? If you continue to attack that shooter, now you're making him work on the defensive end that makes him take his legs away on the offensive end.
Nice pace, sets it up, and slams it down.
Jason Tatum finished third amongst all rookies in Rookie of the Year voting. But I say to you this, I agree with what Jaylen Brown had to say. If it was a one-on-one battle, who you taking, Jason Tatum or Donovan Mitchell? Jason Tatum or Ben Simmons? I take JT every time.
Message received. Well defended. Warriors have the basketball. Curry shakes three and hits.
Well, the defense has been good, but the shot-making ability has been better. And sometimes for NBA players at this level, the more you're in their face, the more it helps them center their focus on the target, which is making the shot. I know it sounds weird, but trust me, it's a real thing, man.
Horford. Here comes the screen to Jaylen Brown. No good. Defense catching a break there. Green to Thompson. Here's a chance from long range. Tatum grabs the rebound. Hayward to Horford. It goes down. He improvises and scores.
That's a good run right here to end the first quarter to open up that lead. If you're the coach of this team, you have to like the effort your guys are giving.
We get a whistle and a timeout by Golden State as they'll talk things over here in the first quarter. We have both squads set to make some moves right now. Points to the board.
You can finally see this team starting to get their rhythm and their groove offensively. This is a good run to get them back in the ball game.
KD with the rock and stuffs it home.
That's the kind of defense they're going to play on him all night. Even though he made that shot, he knows there's nothing easy about this game.
Turned away by Bell.
Ed, that's light work for a guy with his ability.
Livingston across the timeline. Shot clock's off as they search for a tying bucket. Now a three at the buzzer, and it's no good as time's run out here in the first quarter. That'll do it for the first quarter. Second quarter set to begin. Some impressive shooting numbers. Jay, is that good offense, or is it, dare we say, bad defense?
Well, the offense is hitting on all cylinders. Great ball movement, great shooting, great passing. But my goodness, has the defense been horrific. Can we do something about that, please, in the second quarter?
Ed Cohen, Jay Williams with you as we get things started here in the second quarter. It's Golden State basketball to Green. To Thompson. To Sean Livingston. Down low Bell. It's denied by Horford.
Just incredible timing on that swat.
Well, it took a while, Jay, but he hits his first three of the game here tonight.
Yeah, couldn't really get one to fall in the first quarter, but he stayed the course and did a good job of squaring his shoulders to the basket.
And Kyrie Irving took the defense for a ride. Tough three-pointer. Kyrie Irving won a championship with Cleveland. He won a championship for Cleveland in that Game 7 at Golden State. How is he influenced as a player by that title?
Well, I thought he learned how to win at a really huge stage. But Kyrie's always been a leader of his own movement. At times, his voice may have been suppressed because of LeBron James, but there's no doubt about it. When you look at the young players on his roster, when they all rock Kyrie's, you know who the leader of the team is.
Nice touch around the basket with the tip.
He's been doing this for years. The physicality in which he plays, no one wants to see that. You're going to leave the game with black and blue marks all over your body.
Warriors basketball to Thompson. Knocked loose. Out of bounds. Last touch by the Celtics. It remains Warrior basketball. Steve Kerr gets some new personnel on the floor. The three, and he can't get it to go down. It's no good. Off the assist.
You used to hear all these coaches talk about, we need players to run the floor. No, I don't need you to run the floor. I need you to run the floor with purpose. Those are two different things. When you run the floor in attack mode, that's when plays like this occur.
Kevin Durant has it. To Cousins. Slams it down.
I mean, with so much talk these days about three-point shooting and the spacing on the court and having versatile athletic wings, sometimes when you have a dominant big man, you keep giving him the ball. You let him be that anomaly.
Tough shot. Well defended.
Just because you're an elite shooter doesn't mean you need to shoot the ball every possession. Maybe give a head fake, crack into the defender, get to the free throw line, see the ball go in the hole.
That's how you defend. Thompson to bring it into the front court. Down four. Curry knocks it down. Defender has to get there next time.
I know there are refs on the court all the time, but it doesn't mean they can see every play. Maybe defensively, grab his jersey, step on his toe, do something to kind of change up his pace.
Hayward to Horford. Has a look. Buries it on the catch and shoot.
Leadership's greatest values occur in between the lines and not necessarily in the box score. And that's the type of leader that Al Horford is. He's the first All-Star free agent to choose Boston in decades. And let me tell you this, the legacy of greatness runs deep in the family. His father, Tito Horford, was the first Dominican basketball player to ever play in the league, which goes to show you why Al has such a great feel for the game.
Kevin Durant with the rock. To Thompson. Driving right to the basket. First free throw is good. Good free throw shooting. Knocks down a pair. Rozier with it. Final minute, first half. To Marcus Morris. 4-3. Second effort.
I want the foul.
Stays out
because he had no body control. You have to be able to control your body when you attack the rim at full speed.
And a putback slam.
And when you get your prescription, you take your medicine and you call it a day.
Curry to Thompson. Pass to Cousins. Down low. Whoa! What a finish!
Well, when you play for each other and not just for yourself, that's when great things happen. You essentially lose yourself in what the team is trying to accomplish. It's called unselfish basketball. And there's nothing more beautiful than rewarding your teammate with a nice pass and letting them finish for 2 or 3 points.
KD for two. Just not going down.
And this is where you know you have the offense right where you want them. Every possession, all you see them doing is complaining to the ref, complaining to each other. You're making the game uncomfortable. That's the mark of a good defense.
So a tight one as we reach the break in a one-point game.
The Warriors have themselves a close. Thanks for joining us for the halftime report. The second
I'm
half,
like this.
The boss gets started.
Kyrie Irving, Jason Tatum, Marcus Morris. Let's go. Matchup.
Second effort.
Oh, dunk. Oh my God.
That time. And that's next level defense. The defender took away the pocket space of the shooter. Now, as a shooter, they shoot hundreds of shots each and every day from that pocket with consistency. Now you force them to change the angle or the positioning of that pocket, you're going to lower the chances of them making that shot.
Takes it right to the rim. A lot of contact there, but they say...
And all around on that layup with the offense winning that battle. But if the defense keeps up that kind of pressure, good things are bound to happen.
Slams it home on the putback. 6'11", 270. That's a massive man. You can make a case there's nobody like him.
There isn't anybody like him in the NBA. He is an absolute bully on the block. Can burrow his way through traffic, make it easy, and also possesses that sweet shooting touch from the outside.
Textbook defense.
Shooters shoot. Period. I don't want to hear any excuses. That's why you're on the floor. You keep doing what you're doing with that superior confidence.
To Marcus Morris from long range.
That's what the fuck?
The rim. Short. To Curry. And throws it down.
He's a modern day big that plays like a 6'2 guard. Scary.
To Jaylen Brown. Hayward to Horford. Oh, emphatic slam. Jay, let's see if that's a sign for him.
Well, he's been pretty much non-existent the first three quarters. But when you have a play like that, that can get the juices going, and that can help you with your offensive rhythm.
Curry, runner here, won't go down. Brown, into the front court. His guy's down three. Plenty of contact. The shot, no good. The follow won't go either.
Here's a message to the defender. I know you're here physically, but I have zero clue where you are mentally. You have to contest a shot. That's what defense means.
Not going down here.
This always happens. You knock down a lot of shots in the first half, and in the second half, you start to lose your rhythm. You need to have legs. Shoot at the pinnacle of that jump.
Warriors have the basketball. Curry. That won't go. On the follow. Way to stay with it.
I remember my high school coach said one man can't beat five. Well, I'm telling you right now, he lied. I'm watching it happen in person.
Hayward, deep right corner. Rozier, knocks it down from three.
The post-shot confidence is everything. He's still running down the court, holding his extension.
Curry to bring it up. His guys now down by a point. Count the basket. Two more points in the paint.
Well, you know what the old saying is. When you assume, you make a... You know what I'm talking about. You can't fault the D too much there. I was expecting to kick out.
Bad pass there. Warriors have it.
Here's watch out.
With it up top.
No.
Leads one. Curry, it's no good. Great defense.
And that's next level defense. The defender took away the pocket space of the shooter. Now, as a shooter, they shoot hundreds of shots each and every day from that pocket with consistency. Now you force them to change the angle or the positioning of that pocket, you're going to lower the chances of them making that shot.
And stuffs it down.
Well, the shooting has been spectacular, but one of the things that I've seen as a difference maker in this ballgame is how they are catching the basketball. They're not establishing a pivot point, which leaves the defense wondering which way you can drive. But when that shot is working like that, you got it any way you want.
Both coaches hitting the reset button.
Now let's go.
Legs coming onto the floor. Livingston to Thompson. Down low to Cousins. From the painted area, won't go down. to Jaylen Brown. Inside, he scores. Jay, would you classify him among the elites in the game, especially among wings?
It depends on what category of elite you put him in. As of right now, he will be my second-tier elite. Because when I think first-tier elite, I think Kevin Durant, LeBron James, Stephen Curry, Kawhi Leonard, Anthony Davis, James Harden. I think Gordon Hayward has a chance to be there. He was on his way there before he got hurt, but time will tell.
Possession lies with Golden State. Livingston to Thompson. Surveys the floor. Livingston. Screen coming. To Thompson. Beyond the arc for three. Won't go down.
And there's always so much talk about defense. How about offensively? If you continue to attack that shooter, now you're making him work on the defensive end that makes him take his legs away on the offensive end.
Defense forces the turnover, and it leads to points.
And the true test of a team's character is how they respond when they get hit in the mouth.
Keep digging. Iguodala to bring it up. The margin standing now at 7. The drive right to the basket. Got a piece of it.
Jumping out the gym right now, Ed.
Great anticipation. Knocked loose. Celtics have it. Let's it fly from beyond the arc. That's off the side of the rim. No good. Deep three at the buzzer. That ends the third quarter with the Celtics in front. It's been a compelling game so far. The fourth quarter is underway. And too much contact.
What?
His timing was a tad
bit off. Man.
And a whistle.
Timing was just a tad bit off.
Put this
Curry, and he buries it.
And in today's game, you have to make shots like that. Nice work,
Curry. Curry, 4-3, and he scores.
And Green able to pull down the rebound.
No.
He's been dialed in from long distance. That's now 5 threes for the game.
Nothing more painful
than the next day watching tape, seeing the fact that
watch
he got
this.
15 points off 3 points.
Golden State at the controls. Shot in the lane won't go.
Dunk.
Nice pace, sets it up and slams it down.
Sometimes when the players find that flow, nobody else needs to touch the ball. He's in the zone by himself.
Curry with the basketball. Down three. And they call it.
No. 3 fouls. Kyrie with me. 3 fouls. 4 fouls. So the last foul.
Curry. He's not shy about shooting from out there, but he misses this time. Hayward to Irving. Let's it fly from long range. It's good.
Oh my God. Yeah.
Most definitely contact on that forearm during the follow through. You have to give the offensive player a lot of credit. The concentration you need to make a shot after
it will be 4 points by Ryu Kyrie. It's 4 points.
And he hits. Curry with the ball to Durant, and the defender over pursues and he calls a simple touchback. Curry, it's the Celtics with the rebound. Here's Irving into the front court. Lead stands at 7. Hayward, count it. 3-pointer is good.
Defense due to math. You force him to take tough twos. You'll probably have a better chance to win this game if you can slow down the pace.
Curry to Thompson. To Durant. Bad pass, and the Celtics have it. And a throwdown.
That's what I'm talking about. Nice finish. It's all business.
Curry into the front court. The deficit now up to a dozen. Cousins to shot clock violation. Time to shuffle things up. Irving to Hayward.
Oh, yeah.
Basket inside.
That's a strong finish. Regardless of contact, finishing strong is key.
Warriors have the basketball. Here comes the screen. Probing the defense. Not done yet. Oh, and a putback.
And there's nothing more mentally intimidating for your opponent than when your own teammates are unselfish and make sure that you get the ball because they want you to drop 70 on them, maybe like Devin Booker did last year.
Livingston to bring it up. Down a dozen. Durant lets it fly. Can't connect. To Irving.
Everything three.
And if you're on D right now, if you're off on the weak side, stunt
towards
the
driver.
I mean, fake at him. Don't overcommit. Stunt, then get back to you or stay at home. Force him to make one of those passes or force him to take a crazy shot at the
What the fuck, though?
Download Boogie.
No.
And watch him do the rest. Slam dunk.
And easy two. Get back on defense.
To Horford.
But look at this.
To Hayward.
Tatum, 4-3. What the fuck, man? Get the screen. Hey, the screen, man.
To Irving. For three. Great defense, forcing the miss.
Just because you're an elite shooter doesn't mean you need to shoot the ball every possession. Maybe give a head fake, crack into the defender, get to the free throw line, see the ball go in the hole.
Bad shot.
He was all over him. Livingston across the timeline. The deficit now up to 13. Oh, the whistle. Hey, take your hands off of it.
Ed, you can't lunge like that.
Two fucks, I think. Yes.
First one goes down.
Okay, good game. But who wins?
No back-to-back free throws here. He missed the second. Hayward to Jaylen Brown. Going along.
Score.
Beyond the arc. Brown with the three with a hand in his face.
Look, that shot was going up regardless of what the defender was trying to do. That's called a heat check.
Thompson. Oh, they called the
foul. They hit it. Like
he's got a steal.
What?
Connects on the first free throw. And he makes them both. Celtics have it. Hayward. That's good D. Shot no good.
Great contest by the D, but I want to see the coaching staff call the same exact play the next possession. Get that offensive player the ball. Let him prove that it wasn't the D. It was more in his own head.
Count the basket, and it could have been more. No whistle.
Contact on a drive can be a beautiful thing. Making those tough shots can really help you build a mental advantage over your defender.
Off the three at the buzzer. It's a victory.
And that does it for our post-game wrap-up. On behalf of ESPN on EA Sports, I'm Jalen Rose.
Thank you for watching. Subscribe for a poor gamer. Thank you for watching, guys. Goodbye, guys.